Hello, and welcome to the second episode of Coding Butterfly's channel. I'm Brian, and today I'll introduce you to Scratch and show you how it's helping kids to get started with programming. But first, I'd like to take you back to your own childhood and remind you of one of the most popular games of that era, Tetris. The code for Tetris has been written in many different computer programming languages. Today I'll show you how it can be done with Scratch. If you haven't heard of it, Scratch is a software that helps kids create their own games. It was developed and first released in 2007 by the MIT Media Lab. As of today, Scratch has over 28 million registered users and is rapidly being included in school curriculums for all ages. Today we'll be showing you how Scratch can be used to create amazing games through the use of both creativity and programming. Students can come up with a cool game idea and make it the way they want, which helps them to understand the inner workings of a computer. Applying this creative ability through technical methods also helps build cognitive skills as part of the child's learning experience. Kids can make a ton of fun games such as the iconic Tetris, which we'll be showing you today. Tetris was invented by a Russian scientist back in 1984. That's over 30 years ago. It has since been played in over 235 countries and has been released on over 50 different platforms. Let's give you a quick overview of how we can use the power of Scratch to create our very own version of Tetris. One of the fundamental components of Scratch are sprites. These are characters in Scratch that you can program to perform different actions, like moving around the screen. In Tetris, the main characters are the tetrominoes, which are those blocks that fall down continuously. For our game, we'll create three tetrominoes: the long one, the angled one, and the simple square. Now that the blocks are created, Scratch has a programming area which can be used to help bring the blocks to life. On the top, you'll be able to see the start button, which is a green flag. Beside it is the red stop button, which stops the game. Over here, you can see the different colored drawers which contain the programming blocks. The way Scratch works is these blocks can be joined together like a puzzle to help create a program. For example, if we want to move a tetronimo when the game is started, we can take out the when flag clicked and attach the move 10 steps block from the blue motion drawer. See how the grooves line up like a puzzle to help make the connection? Now, when we press the start button, you'll be able to see that the block will now move 10 steps each time the button is clicked. For Tetris, we will need to combine several blocks for other functions, such as controlling the game using the arrow keys, getting the blocks to fall down constantly, and getting them to stop while stacking on top of each other. There are several options in Scratch to help make this possible, such as the forever block. The forever block is basically a loop, which repeats anything that's placed inside it. Loops are a fundamental part of computer programming, and including them in a child's early education really helps them to understand how computers work. Scratch is full of examples like this, such as the if-else block, which is another fundamental programming concept. Moving on to our game, we can add other blocks for the movement of sprites, like go to XY block, which helps the sprite move along the X and Y axes on the screen. This is a concept of math that subtly comes into the game and results in the child getting a better understanding of these mathematical concepts without studying for it. Once all the blocks are joined together, the child can start the game and challenge their friends to play it. They can also customize the game according to their liking by adding backgrounds that they can choose from the library or creating their own. Also, there are creative instances where the kids have changed the design of the tetrominoes to something of their liking, such as fruits and sports items. The games they have made can also be uploaded to the official Scratch website, where other kids can play the game while also looking inside and seeing the programming to understand how it works. Now that you've seen how Scratch can be used to make a classic game like Tetris without a lot of difficulty, You can also check out the link below in the description to visit the Scratch website to check out all of the other cool stuff that children around the world have been creating. Scratch is not just a tool that kids use to create their own games, but it also introduces them to programming in a way that they'll be learning while playing. The download link for Scratch, the latest version currently available, is provided below. We hope that you get started with this amazing platform so your kids can enjoy making games themselves using their own creativity to become creators instead of consumers. If you're in the Boston area, check out our list of programs for kids at codingbutterfly.com. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to this channel to find out more about amazing technologies that are coming up to help us move education into the 21st century.